everybody, it's Kimberly Eichelle, and welcome to another edition of Talented Television. I'm at 1500 South Las Vegas Boulevard. That's right, Legends Restaurant, where there's good music, good food, good fun, and a great atmosphere. If you haven't been here yet, what are you waiting for? Now, for those of you that are new, I need you to press that subscribe button. And for those of you that haven't, come on, I'm waiting on you. This episode is featuring a young lady who is blowing up in every arena. Right now, you can find her in this month's edition of OWN magazine. Also on Netflix in a movie entitled Thriller. Stay tuned, Miss Teshi Thomas. To Talented Television. I am your host, Kimberly Eichelle, and look who we have here, Miss Teshi Thomas.
Hi.
Say hey!
Hi, guys.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for coming. Yes. I'm excited to see you again.
Oh, it's good to see you as well.
Thank you. Yes, so I want to talk about your story a little bit. Mm-hmm. First of all, do you tell your age?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so let them know how old you are.
I'm 16 years old.
So 16 years old. We're going to go back and talk about Teshi's story a little bit. This girl, she's done some of everything, and I want you all to really hear, especially my young people out there, what this young lady has done in such a short time. So let's talk about your acting first.
Yes,
okay?
Okay.
Awesome. So you started acting around age?
I want to say seven.
Okay.
Seven.
Okay, around age seven. Mm-hmm. And how did you know that you were able or wanted to be an actress or an actor?
Well, for acting, because for singing, like, I started like around age three.
Okay.
But for acting, I was coming out of school one day, mm-hmm. and this woman had came up to me and my mom and was like, "What are you doing right now? Mm-hmm. Go to this audition." And I was like, "I really don't act, but, like, you know, why not try and give it a try and see what I can do?" And so I went, I gave it my all, and from there I started to love being on stage and, like, you know, sharing my story with, like, an audience who was willing to watch it, you feel?
So, awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. So you said you started singing around 3 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. So that's kind of like myself. I've been singing about that long as well.
Okay.
So what was your first song? Do you remember?
Yes, it was called "You Are So Beautiful." I'm unaware of the artist.
Okay.
But the song
I believe
was,
Ray Charles may have done it.
Maybe. There's so many people have done it
uh-huh.
in so many different ways.
Exactly.
It's just like, that's a good song to me.
Yes.
That was my first song because my grandfather gave me this puppet before he had passed away, and it was mm-hmm. this, like, little frog that I would play with every now and then. And one day I just sat there and was, like, listening and repeating, like, what the frog would say.
Mm-hmm.
And my mom had came in one day and was like, "What are you doing?" And I was like, "Mom, I want to be a singer, you know?"
Wow.
So that's basically.
So you knew early on what your career was going to be, right?
Yes.
Awesome. So tell me about your first play. How did you feel getting up on stage? Were you nervous?
Wow. Oh, for sure. There was this one moment, because I'd always have to, like, run and do something before, right before I had to go on stage. Mm-hmm. And like the stage manager would be like, where's Teshi? Like, where is she? Like, she's not in her place. Uh-huh. And there's one moment where I was like running because my part was getting ready to come up. And I slid on stage, made it on time.
Oh my goodness.
And I was like, bam, here I am.
Exactly.
Nobody knew, but the people backstage, and I'm just like, oh no.
This Teshi again, huh?
Yeah, but nerves are always a thing for me, but I don't mm-hmm. consider nerves to be a bad thing because it shows how much you care, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, yeah, when nerves, I don't have them as much anymore, but mm-hmm. like they come on and off. That's not necessarily a bad thing.
It's not necessarily a bad thing. And especially when you can push through those nerves,
right.
It means you're doing something that you really enjoy,
yes.
right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So let's talk about growing up a little bit. Did you grow up here in Las Vegas?
Yes, born and raised.
Born and raised. Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yes.
And what was it like going to school and things like that? Was it always a great experience for you?
Well, I stopped going to public school, I want to say, grade 4.
Okay.
I had to move to New York for a year and a half. I played young Nala in The Lion King on Broadway.
Wow.
And so being there, I had to switch over to homeschool, mm-hmm. and I'm still doing homeschooling, online school. And doing that, it's helped a lot, mm-hmm. especially being in like public school, I used to get bullied.
Okay.
And the environment at school, it's not bad, but
yeah.
there are some kids who may be insecure about themselves and then put their feelings out towards you.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I just hurt people.
Yes,
you feel?
Indeed.
So, but being with online school, it's much easier.
Mm-hmm.
And I can travel easily without worrying about missing a class or, you
right.
know, their understanding of what I do, and they support what I do, which is really good to know.
Yes, it is. So I know that you took kind of what you've been through, the bullying and things like that, and you turned it into something positive.
Yes.
So tell me some of the things that you've done to kind of help other students or kids out there that have been bullied.
Well, yes, I was a part of an online radio show, and I am a part of Bully Buster 702.
Okay.
And I'm all about non-bullying, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's never good to hurt people or like judge people for what they wear, what they want to do, and what they want to achieve. And
right.
that was me. So I wanted to take part on showing people that it's okay to do what you want to do.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now I want to piggyback on something because you said fourth grade.
Yes.
You achieved a dream that sometimes people never reach in their career.
Right.
And you did what?
I played young Nala in The Lion King.
Wow.
And I never would have guessed. I was,
uh-huh.
we were sitting down and we had got this call from my agent. She was like, hey, do you want to audition for something? I was like, mm-hmm. yeah, sure, what is it? She was like, yeah, you want to audition for young Nala in The Lion King on Broadway in New York? And I was like, oh, I didn't know this is what I wanted to audition
uh-huh.
for. And
something
like,
major,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, why not, you know? And mm-hmm. so, yeah, drove to L.A. and filmed the audition. And then, I want to say like a week later, we got mm-hmm. a call saying that they wanted to see us in New York. So they flew
wow.
us out. And I got a call back, and man, that was crazy.
That's amazing.
Yeah, and to be in a room full of, you know, beautiful black girls, mm-hmm. women, you know, just to be surrounded by that energy is always great to my heart. And
yes.
it was crazy because I was the only kid who came in natural.
Okay.
You know, like I had these big puffs,
mm-hmm.
and I dressed in all black, barefoot, and these other girls had like ballet shoes
uh-huh.
and their pigtails, Shirley Temples, you know.
Right.
And like just colorful, but like I felt that it didn't matter. I came in natural, or, you know, I just came in ready to learn mm-hmm. and ready to achieve what I wanted to get. And thankfully, I got it. And that's still mind-boggling to me.
Yes.
But yeah, I couldn't be more grateful for
that's awesome.
For mm-hmm.
Awesome. And I know kind of what that experience can be like, because many years ago, mm-hmm. I auditioned in Atlanta for Dreamgirls.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
And so being in that room and waiting with all those women that could sing and blow and all of that. So it's a very, it can be a nerve-wracking thing, but at the same time, when you go in and you're positive and you put your best foot forward, there's nothing that can stop you, right?
Exactly.
What was your experience like in New York, being a Vegas girl?
Whoa.
So you were in the heat all the time. What was it like living on the East Coast all of a sudden?
You got every season in a week, you know, maybe even in a day.
Uh-huh.
Having to ride the subway to work every day was like pretty insane, but like that's what I miss most, as well as like the environment mm-hmm. out there, being around so many creative minds that were out there. Like I got a little homesick when mm-hmm. I first moved out there. I was like, you know what, I want to go back so bad. But living out there and like having to adjust out there, I love it. And whenever I get a chance to go back, I'm like, yes!
Yes!
It's so awesome out there. Yeah.
That's amazing. And I haven't even been to New York yet.
Oh, man.
That's my dream. I want to go to the Apollo.
Yes.
I want to definitely go to Broadway.
Yes.
And I just want to be that tourist.
Yeah.
Just buy some pizza and t-shirt.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, man. It's like when people say they have New York pizza in like a different state, it's not the same.
You like, that's not New York pizza,
yes.
huh?
That pizza over there, that's a whole different, you can't do that.
My gosh.
You gotta try it sometime.
Right?
Sure.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Well, you gotta get back to Broadway so I can come and see you, right?
Yes, I
yes.
I hope to.
Indeed.
I want to be able to audition for older Nala
mm-hmm.
When I'm old enough.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's something that I would like to look forward to. To go back on Broadway. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes, I love that. You are a natural beauty.
Thank you.
Yes, indeed. How important is it to you to kind of stand out and be different and be okay with being different?
Yes. I always want to make sure that my health, my mental health is mm-hmm. okay before I do anything that I'm unsure of, or, you know, I just want to make sure that I feel comfortable with doing what I'm doing, especially with auditioning for so many things.
Mm-hmm.
You get no's, and in the beginning of that process, it was tough on me because I was like, what's wrong with me? And I didn't know if it was a me thing.
Yeah.
But growing up and doing this process so many times, auditioning for so many roles and characters, I realized that it wasn't a me thing. It's what they're looking for. And
right.
That's nothing I can do, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I just have to go in and show what I am able to put on the character that they asked me to do for. And
mm-hmm.
I just give my all. And that's really all you can do.
I love it. I love it. You're very mature for 16.
Thank you so much.
Yes, indeed.
Thank
and I've
you.
Been around you for a little bit, right?
Yes.
Yes. We actually did a show together, or two shows together, I believe, right?
Yes, yes.
So, yes, with that being said, this young lady played my granddaughter.
Yes.
Play my granddaughter in a show, and you are able to kind of take a role
mm-hmm.
and take it on.
Yeah.
And I remember seeing you kind of break down on the stage. The play was written by Preston, right? And Preston Coghill, I should say. Shout out to Preston out there.
Yes.
But he wrote that beautiful play that dealt with Alzheimer's called OldTimers.
Yes.
And for me, doing that role, It was one of the most challenging roles that I had ever done.
Yeah, you played the role.
Thank you so much.
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
Bringing it back to me. You played the role.
Thank you.
Yes, you did.
Yes, it was challenging. So studying, and watching patients with Alzheimer's and things like that, I had to detox, afterwards because going through that action on stage and really feeling like I was alone and didn't know really what was going on was very challenging.
It was.
So how do you detox?
Ooh.
Because you have to take on all these different characters,
yes.
But how do you get back to Teshi?
Oh, wow. That's a good question there. I'd have to say, even though I love traveling so much,
mm-hmm.
it's good to come home
yeah.
and be in my room and have time to myself because, mm-hmm. After taking on a character, it's like, man, Teshi, where is she?
Yeah.
It's like, I have to go back to what makes me, if mm-hmm. that makes sense.
Absolutely.
And, just being in my room, listening to music. I literally listen to music and find new music every single day.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like music calms me and that's just my safe place. My room is my safe place.
I love that.
Yeah, so that's usually how I'm able to recover and heal mm-hmm. from all the work that I've done.
Yes, because it is a healing process,
yes.
To kind of get back to self and take off what you have to wear as an
yes.
actor, So that's a beautiful thing. So let's talk about your singing a little bit,
okay.
So you were talking about music being that healing place for you.
Yes.
What type of music do you like? Who do you like to listen to?
Oh, wow.
What do you like to sing? And where do you like to sing? Where do you like to express yourself?
Wow, okay, so.
I gave you a whole bunch of questions,
didn't I?
Pow.
I'd have to say where I usually sing a lot is like late night in my room. I have like these lights around my room and I
yes.
can change colors and
mm-hmm.
so however I'm feeling, I'll put that color on, I'll put on a song and sing or harmonize to it
just for fun.
Wow, I listen to literally every genre there is.
Mm-hmm.
So much as like country or anything,
okay.
but
not yet.
I literally will find something and it's like, wow, okay, all right, this is what I'm listening to. I rarely listen to the radio anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I listen to more, I don't want to say underground artists, but like people who don't get as much recognition as they should.
Right.
So I try to support them as artists because,
that's awesome.
They should be shown for their work as well.
Absolutely.
Wow, I love Etta James. I love,
nice.
I love so many people.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even.
You like, I
down.
Can't even name
Stevie
them.
Wonder.
Oh, yes.
Of course. And.
You got an old soul.
So many. Oh, because of my mom. That's yeah. She put me on early. Who was it? Yeah, she used to put on classical music
mm-hmm.
when I was little. And so I listened to like the instruments, and that's why I'm so key with listening to like the deep instruments that are in a song that
mm-hmm.
most people can't listen to. Like I'll find the beat and they're like, where do you hear that? I'm like, no, it's in there.
It's
you just
in
gotta
there.
You gotta listen. And so that's what I do.
I love it. Let's talk about your mom a little bit.
Yes.
Cause you and your mom are very close.
My
and
best friend.
Yes.
Yeah.
You've been on this journey together. So tell me about your mom.
Man, my mom is my heart, my world.
I love it.
I can't thank her enough for, traveling with me, being an only child.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, it's insane on how much we've had to sacrifice and how much she's had to sacrifice.
Right.
While traveling with me and helping me achieve my dream. And so I'm glad that she can be there with me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's so sweet. Shout out Miss Evonne.
Yes.
Yes, indeed. A great mom out there working hard for this beautiful girl.
Thank you.
Teshi, What do you have for me today?
Okay.
I want you to be comfortable.
Okay.
I don't know if you want to sing something for me. If okay. you want to do a little jig, because this girl dances as well. She's a camp counselor. When I tell you that she does some of everything,
yeah.
literally at age 16, and I can't believe she's 16. You told me the other day you're doing what now?
Oh, I'll be attending a camp this summer. Mm-hmm. I'll be an intern.
Yes.
It's for PVAC.
Wow.
And we do this every summer, and we'll be putting on a very wonderful project by the end of this summer.
Mm-hmm.
And so when that information comes out, I'll be sure to share that with you as well.
Please do.
Yes.
Please do. And you're driving now, right?
Yes. Yes.
You saw that happy
like,
face?
I have my permit, but you
yes.
know, yeah. I'm
That's awesome.
Whipping it a little bit, you know. Yeah.
So she's growing
yeah.
up.
Yes.
And then let's just share one more awesome little piece before I let you do your thing.
Okay.
This young lady has a huge project right now, right?
Yes.
So, you ready to tell me about it?
Yes.
Let the audience know what you're doing.
Okay, so I am a part of a show that will be showing on OWN August 14th, and it's called David Makes Man.
Yes.
And wow, filming this show, I couldn't be more excited for it.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the things that I really dug into, especially I was out of my comfort zone. I am a hip hop dancer. I'm becoming more well-rounded with other styles of dance, but I had to step out of my comfort zone to do modern dance.
Nice.
And I really enjoyed doing that. And it's crazy. And I saw like a couple of clips and it's just like, wow, I did that.
You're like, that's me.
Yeah, and all the people on set are so sweet and so, like, they gave me hope and it just kept me pushing. And
I love
gave
it.
Gave me, you know, all the support that I needed to
yes.
get through that because it was pretty stressful.
Right.
It's pretty, pretty stressful. But at the end of the day, I was really proud of how far I came
mm-hmm.
and the amount of support that I was given as well.
Yes, and I am proud of you, Teshi.
Thank you.
You are doing your thing.
Thank you so much.
And you're representing Las Vegas so well. And not just Las Vegas, you're representing our girls everywhere. You know, to let them know that they can achieve their dreams even at an early age.
Yes.
Yes, indeed.
You're watching Talented Television with Kimberly Isha.
Teshi and I are about to do something fun. Take it away, Teshi. It's
okay.
your show now.
All right. Okay, so we can do a little riff if we want.
You okay.
know, just a little scale, if we'll call it that.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to say, Mommy made me munch my M&M's, munch crunch.
Mmm, you got me singing,
yes,
okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
All right, here we go.
You can do it,
I was not sure what was coming. Okay.
Yes.
So you said, Mommy made me munch my M&M's, munch crunch.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yeah, yeah. It's just something that helps me like make sure I'm articulating,
uh-huh.
and everything's clear while I'm singing as well.
Yes, that's fun. I'm gonna have to use that.
Yes.
Mommy made me munch. My M&M's. So you gave me a tongue twister.
Yes.
And you had me singing.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see what you're doing to me,
yeah,
Teshi.
You know.
Awesome.
Yes.
So what do you want to share with us today as far as your gift?
Oh, wow. I would like to sing a little something, if that's okay with
of
you.
Of course that's okay.
Okay. My life's a twisting roller coaster on the run. I get no warning when the bad times are gonna come. It's a journey with no certainty. So I'll make my peace with whatever may be. That's how life goes. That's how it goes. So you live and you learn to let go. That's how it goes. Hey guys. guys. You can follow me on my Instagram at teshi.ujani, U-J-A-N-I, as well as for my Facebook, Teshi Thomas. And my YouTube is Teshi Thomas as well. Yes.
Alrighty, everybody. I know that you've enjoyed today's show with this young lady, this young beautiful lady, Miss Teshi Thomas.
Thank you so much.
Yes, indeed.
Oh,
you're very welcome. Thank you all again for watching. Make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell, okay?
Yes.
If you want to keep seeing positive people and positive things and all these talented people in Las Vegas, you have to tell everybody to keep checking out Talented Television. Also, if you're interested in being a part of Talented Television, please email me at talentedtelevision@gmail.com. Until next time, Teshi, you have any final words?
Oh, I just want to say thank you guys for watching. Thank you for having me here.
You're very welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We'll see you all next time.
Bye.
Bye.